Hi, welcome to Microsoft Excel series. Today we are going to learn how to design a spreadsheet for singly reinforced beam. First, let us learn what you mean by singly reinforced beam. A singly reinforced beam, it's a beam that is longitudinally reinforced only in the tension zone. And in such beams, the ultimate bending moment and the tension due to bending will be carried by the reinforcement, while the compression is carried by the concrete. These are some of the examples. It's a simply supported beam where the reinforcement is provided on only one side, that is tension side. And this is the example of cantilever beam. Before watching this video, please check the description box below the video to download the design spreadsheet for the singly reinforced beam. Hi, welcome to our channel Techguru.civil, a channel dedicated to civil engineering education. In this e-learning platform, you are going to learn all the major civil engineering subjects and the laboratories, along with all the major civil engineering softwares which are needed in the industry in the current scenario. If you not yet subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to receive all the notifications. Design of singly reinforced beam. Here the given question is, design a singly reinforced beam of clear span of 5 meter to support a working live load of 15 kN per meter. Adopt M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 steel. Assume bearing equal to 380 millimeters. Here we need to extract the data from the given question and we need to write it in the input table. Here the length will be of 5 meter and live load it is of 15 kN per meter. FCK, that is grade of concrete, that is 20 Newton per mm square, and FY, grade of steel, it is of 415 Newton per mm square, bearing equal to 380 millimeters. Now, bearing it is given in terms of millimeter, let's convert that into meter by dividing by 1000. All the formulas or functions should start with equal symbol, equals, select the bearing value, divided by 1000. Press enter. Next, if you come to the solution part, first we need to find out the effective length, that is given by given length plus thickness of the wall or bearing thickness. So start with equal symbol, length 5 plus bearing thickness 0.38, enter, we got it as 5.38 meter. Let's convert that into millimeter by multiplying by 1000. Equals effective length value multiplied by 1000. So we got 5380 millimeters. Next, if we come to the size of the beam, in that we need to find out the depth of the beam, that is given by effective length divided by 12. We need in terms of millimeter. So start with equal symbol, effective length in terms of millimeter it is 5380 divided by 12. We got it as 448.33 millimeter. So we need to round up that depth value, our desired significance. So what we are going to do means, here I am going to make use of a special function known as ceiling to round up the number. CI, select ceiling by using arrow keys, press tab button, then select the value, press comma. Here the significance, I am going to give it as 100, then close the bracket and press enter. We got it as 500 millimeters. Next, assume clear cover as 25 mm and diameter as 20 mm. Then effective cover is given by clear cover plus diameter by 2. So equals clear cover 25 mm plus, open the bracket, click on the diameter, divided by 2, close the bracket, press enter. Then effective depth is given by overall depth minus effective cover. So equals overall depth is 500 minus effective cover is 35 mm. Press enter, 465 mm. We need in terms of meter also for further calculation. So equals effective depth value divided by 1000. Press enter. 0.465 meters. Then width, it ranges from 1/3 of the depth to 2/3 of effective depth. So start with the equal 1/3 multiplied by effective depth. We need in terms of millimeter. So select the millimeter value, press enter. Then here 2/3 equals, open the bracket, 2/3, then multiplied by effective depth value, enter. Now we need to take the average of these two value, equals average AVE. Select the average function by using the arrow keys, press tab button, then select first number, comma, second number, close the bracket and press enter. Now we need to round off this number. To round off this number, we are going to take the ceiling function, CEI. So select the ceiling function, press tab button, then go to the end, press comma. Significance, I'm going to give it as 50, close the bracket and press enter. We got the width as 250 mm. So provide size of the beam, width by overall depth, that is equal to, since we already calculated, we will bring that value in this particular cell, equals, select B value, click enter, then D equals, overall depth, we got it as 500, click on that value and press enter. We got the values in terms of millimeter. To convert that into meter, divide the values by 1000. So equals, select B value, divided by 1000. Next, select D value, divided by 1000. Press enter. We got the size of the beam as 0.25 by 0.5 meters. Then next one is the calculation of effective span, LE. And that is given by center to center distance between the bearing, that is nothing but effective length. Next one is clear span plus effective depth. We need to take least of these two values. So let us calculate one by one. Center to center distance between the bearing, that is effective length, we already calculated. So we will bring the value in this particular cell, equals. So select the meter value and click enter. Then it is given by clear span plus effective depth, equals, clear span is 5 meter plus effective depth, we calculated it as 0.465 meter. So press enter, we got it as 5.465, another one is 5.38. We need to take least of these two. To find out the least of these two values, we will make use of this special function known as minimum, MIN, then press tab button, select these two values, then close the bracket and press enter. We got it as 5.38 meter. Then next step is load calculation. First, self weight of the beam, it is given by width into depth into density. We need in terms of kilonewton and meter. So start with equal symbol, width is 0.25 multiplied by overall depth, it is 0.5 multiplied by density of the RCC, we will take it as 25, press enter. Then live load, it is given in the question itself. So equals, live load is 15 kilonewton per meter, then press enter. Next one is total load, that is given by sum of self weight plus live load, equals self weight plus live load, press enter. Then ultimate load, it is given by the total load multiplied by 1.5. So 1.5 multiplied by total load value, press enter. So we need to round off this number to our desired significance. For that, we will make use of the function ceiling, equals ceiling, select ceiling, press tab button, then select the value, comma. Here the significance, I need it as 0.5, then close it, press enter. We got it as 27.5 kilonewton per meter. Next one is the calculation of vectored moment mu, that is given by W into L square divided by 8. So equals W is given by 27.5 multiplied by L square, that is effective length. We calculated the effective length as 5.38. For square, we will make use of the power function by using shift 6, then 2 WL square divided by 8. So we got it as 99.496 kilonewton meter. To round off this one, we will make use of the ceiling function. For that, after the equal symbol, start typing ceiling. Now select the ceiling function, press tab button, then open the bracket, go to the end of the formula, then press comma, give the significance as 0.5, then close it, press enter. We got it as 99.5 kilonewton meter. Next step is to check for effective depth D. By equating mu equal to mu limit, that is equal to 0.138 FCK BD square for Fe415 grade of steel, we get D required equal to square root of mu divided by 0.138 FCK into B. So let us write that formula equals, for square root, make use of the function SQRT, press tab button, then open another bracket, then select mu value. It is in kilonewton meter, but we need it in terms of newton millimeter. To convert kilonewton meter to newton millimeter, multiplied by 10 power 6, so 10, power symbol shift 6, 6, close the bracket, divided by, open the bracket, 0.138 multiplied by FCK, FCK it is 20, multiplied by width, we got it as 250 mm, so close the bracket and press enter. If you have some small corrections like opening the bracket and closing the bracket, the Excel will auto rectify that error. Okay, click yes to proceed. We got D required equal to 379.7406 millimeter. Now we need to compare D required with the effective depth, whether it is lesser or larger. So in order to obtain that automatically, we will make use of the if function. So I will rewrite this formula once again, equals if, press tab button. The logic is, if this value D required, if it is less than effective depth, select the effective depth value of 465 mm, press comma. Value, if it is true, it should show it as less than. So the values will be entered in between the double inverted comma. So double inverted comma, less than, then close it, then again press comma. Value, if it is false, it should show it as greater than. So over, then close the bracket and press enter. Now we got it as D required is less than effective depth. Okay, if it is less than or more than, then whether the design is safe or unsafe, we need to get that statement automatically. We will make use of the if function, equals if, press tab button. The logic will be of same. If D required, if it is less than effective depth 465 mm, comma, if it is true, then the design will be safe. So write that statement within the double inverted commas. Write it as design is safe, comma. If it is false, then it will be design is unsafe. Then close the bracket and press enter. Next is the calculation of area of tension reinforcement, ASD. So that is given by mu by BD square. So start with equal symbol, then open the bracket, select the mu value. Since it is in kilonewton meter, to convert that into newton millimeter, multiply it by 10 power 6, 10 power 6, close the bracket, divided by, then open the bracket, BD square, B, we got it as 250 mm, multiplied by effective depth, we got it as 465 mm, square, then close the bracket and press enter. We got the value as 1.84. By referring SP16 table 2, by using FCK and FY value, we will get the PT value. The PT value we will get it as 0.58. Please refer the code book to get the values. Then press enter. Then calculation of AST, that is given by PT BD divided by 100. So let us calculate that one. Equals, open the bracket, AST multiplied by B into D. B we got it as 250 mm, multiplied by D, effective depth. Effective depth we got it as 465 mm, PT BD, open the close the bracket, divided by 100, press enter. We got it as 674.25 mm². Next step is to check for minimum reinforcement, that is AST required equal to 0.85 BD divided by FY. Let us write that formula. Equals, open the bracket, 0.85 multiplied by B into D. B, it is given it as 250 multiplied by D, we got it as 465 mm. So 0.85 B into D divided by FY. FY it is 415, then press enter. We got it as 238.1024. Now we need to compare AST required with the AST provided. To get whether it is lesser than or greater than, we will make use of if function. Equals, if, press tab button, click on the AST required value. If it is less than AST provided value, comma, if it is true, we should show it as lesser than. If it is false, we should show it as greater than. But whatever we need to show, it should be within the double inverted commas. So double inverted comma, less than, close it, comma, value if it is false, double inverted comma, greater than, close it, and close the bracket and press enter. Now we got whether it is lesser than or greater than. Once we get that one, whether our calculation is okay or not okay, we need to find out by using automatic statement obtained in Excel. And to get automatic statement, we will make use of if function. So I will write the if function once again. Equals, if, press tab button. It is asking for logic. Logic is, if AST required, if it is less than AST provided, comma, then it should be okay. Write that statement within the double inverted comma, comma, value if it is false, then it is not okay. Then close the double inverted comma, close the bracket and press enter. Now provide the bore diameter as 20 mm. We need to input this value manually. Okay, then area of a single bore, that is small AST, is given by pi d square divided by 4. So let us calculate that one. Equals, to get the pi value, we can write the numerical value as 3.125, or we can make use of the function pi. Open the bracket, close the bracket, it will give the pi value. Pi multiplied by d square. D is nothing but bore diameter. Select the bore diameter, power 2 divided by 4. We got it as 314.16 mm². Next, to find out the number of bars, we will divide overall AST divided by single AST, nothing but overall area of the steel divided by area of one single bar. So equal to, AST provided is 674.25 divided by Small AST is, we got it as 314.16. Press enter. We got it as 2.14. So we need to round off that number. We will round it to the higher value. So equals, we will make use of the function ceiling. Select the ceiling using arrow keys. Press tab button. Select this value, comma, significance, give it as 1. Then close the bracket and press enter. We got the number as 3. So provide, how many number of bars? To get the number of bars, press equal. We already calculated. Click on this box. Then press enter. 3 number of bars. What will be the diameter? To get that one, press equal. We already written that value manually. So select that value. Then press enter. Therefore, provide 3 number of 20 mm dia as a tension reinforcement. Next, to calculate actual AST provided, the number of bars multiplied by area of a single steel bar. So equals, the number is 3 multiplied by area of a single bar, small AST is 314.16. So press enter. We got it as 942.5 millimeter square. Next step is the design of shear reinforcement given by VU equal to W into L divided by 2. So let us write the formula equals, open the bracket, W we got it as 27.5 multiplied by effective length is 5.38, close the bracket and divided by 2, press enter. We got it as 73.975 kilonewton. To convert that into newton, we will multiply it by 1000 equals, select the value, multiply it by 1000, press enter. Then tau V equal to VU by BD, shear stress, that is, let us write the formula, equal to VU, we need in terms of newton per mm square. So we will select VU value in terms of newton divided by, open the bracket, B into effective depth. Let us select B value, B into effective depth, we got it as 465 mm. Then close the bracket and press enter. We got a tau V value as 0.64 newton per mm square. We need to compare tau V with the tau C maximum value. The tau C maximum value from the IS 456-2000, from the table 20, we will get it as 2.8 newton per mm square. So write that 2.8 value manually. Now we need to check whether it is tau V is lesser than tau C or greater than tau C. In order to get that automatic statement, we will make use of if function. So start with equal, if, press tab button, select the tau V value. Logic is, select tau V if it is less than tau C, comma, if it is true, we need to get it as less than, write it inside the double inverted comma, comma, if it is false, we should get it as greater than. Then close the double inverted comma and press enter. Now we need to calculate percentage of steel, that is given by 100 AST by BD equals, then open the bracket, 100 multiplied by actual AST provided. Actual AST provided is 942.5 millimeter square. Then close the bracket, divided by BD, B into D. So open the bracket, B, we got it as how much? 250 into D, it is 465 mm. Then close the bracket, then press enter. We got it as 0.81%. Next, by referring IS 456-2000 table 19, we will get the tau C value. So the tau C value, we will get it as 0.574. So please refer the IS 456 table 19 to get the tau C value. then we need to check whether the tau v value is lesser or greater than tau c. So in order to get that statement, we will make use of if function. So equals if, press tab button, tau v value is 0.64. if it is less than tau c value, then comma. If it is true, we should write it as less than. Then if it is false, we should get it as greater than. Then close the bracket and press enter. Here there is a logic: if tau v is greater than tau c, there is no need of shear reinforcement. Suppose if tau v is less than tau c, then the shear reinforcement is necessary. In order to get this automatic statement, we will make use of if function. So I have already written here. I will show you. If I will change the logic, if tau v value, we got the tau v as 0.64. if it is less than tau c, where is tau c? This one. Okay, if it is tau v is less than tau c, if it is true, shear reinforcement is necessary. Suppose if it is false, shear reinforcement is not necessary. Press enter. Next, shear carried by the concrete, that is given by tau c into bd. Next, shear carried by the concrete is given by tau c into bd, that is equal to tau c value is 0.574 newton per mm square, but we need in terms of kilonewton. So open the bracket, select that value, divided by 1000 to convert that into newton, kilonewton. Next, we need to calculate shear carried by the concrete, that is given by tau c into bd, that is equal to tau c, open the bracket, tau c we got it as 0.574 newton per mm square, multiplied by b into d. B we get it as 250 mm, multiplied by effective depth, we got it as 465 mm. Then close the bracket. Since tau c value, it is in terms of newton, we need to convert that into kilonewton. To convert that into kilonewton, divide it by 1000. So press enter. We got it as 67.7275 kilonewton. So therefore, balance shear carried by these stirrups, Vw, that is given by Vu minus tau c into Bd, equals Vu is given by 73.975 kilonewton minus tau c Bd is 66.72. press enter. We got it as 7.2475 kilonewton. In terms of newton, so multiply it by 1000, equals, select the value, multiply it by 1000, press enter. Now provide two-legged dash mm dia stirrups. Here we need to input this value manually. Let us take 8 mm as the diameter of the stirrups. Therefore, spacing of the stirrups is calculated by SB equal to 0.87 FY into ASB into D divided by VW. Therefore, ASB is given by 2 times of pi d square divided by 4, that is given by equal to 2 into, open the bracket, pi, that is given by pi, close the open the bracket, close the bracket, multiplied by diameter square, select the diameter, power 2, then divided by 4, close the bracket, then press enter. We got it as 100.53 millimeter square. Therefore, SV is given by equals 0.87 into FY. FY is 415 multiplied by ASV. ASV got as this much, then into effective depth, effective depth, we got it as how much? 465 mm. So next one is divided by VW value. So we will open the bracket in the starting and close it, divided by VW. VW we got it as we need in terms of Newton and millimeter. So select this value in terms of Newton and press enter. Next we need to calculate maximum spacing, that is given by SV. SV we got it as equals 2328. Select that one, press enter. Then spacing for minimum shear reinforcement is given by 0.87 Fy into ASV divided by 0.4 into B. So we will write the formula. Let's start with equal symbol, open the bracket, 0.87 into Fy, select Fy into ASV. Okay, where is ASV? ASV we calculate it as this much, select that one, then close the bracket, divided by 0.4 into B, 0.4 into B width, we got it as 250 mm. So let's select that one, then close the bracket, then press enter. Then spacing we got it as 362 mm. Okay, in order to avoid confusion, I will reduce the number of decimal points. Okay, next it is 0.75 times of the effective depth of the beam, that is equal to 0.75 into effective depth is given by 465, press enter, that is 348.75 mm. And the final one is 300 mm. This one we need to input manually, therefore we need to take the least value out of these four values. To get the least value, we will make use of the function minimum, press tab button, select these numbers, then close the bracket and press enter. It is therefore provide two legged 8 mm dia at 300 mm center to center. Next step is check for deflection. The percentage of steel provided PT we already calculated. So press equal. Therefore, percentage of steel provided is 0.81%. Press enter. Then stress in steel at service loads FS equal to 0.58 Fy into AST required divided by AST provided. So start with equal symbol, 0.58 into Fy into AST required. AST required we calculated, AST required is 674 divided by AST provided is 942, then close the bracket and press enter. Then from the code book we will get KT as 1.4, enter. Then L by D maximum equal to 20 KT equal to 20 into KT value. So press enter, we will get it as 28. Therefore L by D provided is given by equal to effective length divided by effective depth. Effective length it is given it as 5380 divided by effective depth, it is 465, enter, we get it as 11.57. So we need to check whether L by D maximum it is lesser or greater than L by D provided. To get that one, we will make use of if statement. We already discussed about the if statement, you can make use of that one. Okay, and we need to get automatic statement whether it is okay or not okay by using if statement. Make use of the same logic.